A fresh warning against Ombudsman Conchita Carpio Morales from Malacañang. The government's top lawyer reiterates Morales will face the consequences if she really decides against implementing the 90-day preventive suspension imposed by the Office of the President on overall Deputy Ombudsman Melchor Arthur Carandang for allegedly exposing the allegedly spurious bank accounts of the President. This after Morales declared she won't turn her back on her duty to call out violations of jurisprudence, which for Morales, the palace disobeyed when it imposed a suspension. Morales even said that this violation by the palace should not be permitted. But the Solicitor General says it is Morales who should be countenanced if she keeps her word.
He was given 10 days. We have options. We can even file a case against the ombudsman for cuddling this Carandang.
The ombudsman, like Morales, can only be held accountable by impeachment, but the House has yet to act on the case filed by the Volunteers Against Crime and Corruption in December 2017 because no congressman has endorsed it. Kalida says Morales' statements may lead to a crisis.
We are ready to defend the actions of the Office of the President.
But Morales insisted that the Supreme Court already invalidated the President's disciplinary authority over her deputies. Albay Representative Edsel Lagman insists jurisprudence is already considered among the laws of the land the president is duty-bound to implement. For former UP College of Law Dean Pacifico Agabin, the palace should have just filed a case against Carandang before Morales' office.
Because of the principle of independence and separation of powers, it is only the ombudsman which can discipline the deputy.
Agabin now wants the palace to file a petition at the Supreme Court to compel the enforcement of the order. Former Senator Rene Sagisag also tells both sides to settle their differences before the High Court.
Malacañang should set an example in following the rule of law.
Kalida is confident he can get a reversal of the 2014 jurisprudence, insisting the Carandang issue is not analogous to the case of Deputy Ombudsman Emilio Gonzalez, who got the Supreme Court to reverse his dismissal by the Aquino administration. Kalida says Morales is using her own interpretation of the ombudsman's independence to cover up her own shortcomings. Carandang assumed jurisdiction over the president's case after Morales inhibited from that case. The president's son-in-law is a nephew of Morales. Kalida cites the residual powers of the president under the Constitution and the Administrative Code in acting on Carandang's case.
The ombudsman at that time, she's still the ombudsman now, kowtowed to the wishes of the executive department. But now, the ombudsman now is cuddling this Carandang. Who will now punish Carandang? That would be a travesty of justice if we don't. The executive doesn't act.
The executive is merely waiting for the lapse of the 10-day grace period for Carandang to comply with the suspension order before making its move. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.